How's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. I hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you some useful functions related to strings in C++. Let's get into it. This video is going to be more of a showcase of the different string functions that are available to us, so we're going to be covering a lot of them. If there's any that you want to see in particular, look in the description for any timestamps and you can hop around if you want. We're going to kick this off with the string.length function. This returns the length of a string that you specify, so let me show you how this works then. We're going to create a string named, perhaps first name. And we're not going to assign this quite yet because we're going to accept some user input. Now we're going to see out a prompt. Enter your first name. And then we're going to use getLine. Cin, comma, first underscore name. We can use the length function to determine how long our name is, and we can actually store this as an integer variable. Or we don't have to, but I'll show you a good use. So length equals whatever string that we want to determine what the length is. So first name dot length, and then a set of parentheses. So you'll notice with a lot of these functions that they will end with a set of parentheses. So pay attention to that. All right, so we have our length. Now what? Well, I'll show you a good use then. We can check to see if somebody's name is too long. Like if they create a username, we can determine if it's too long or not. We can have them choose something else. So perhaps if, leave this within parentheses, length is greater than or equal to 12, then what we will do is display a message. Your name can't be over 12 characters long. Okay. Else, see out. Welcome. Then we'll display your first name. All right, let's try this. Enter your first name. I'll just type in bro. Welcome, bro. All right, so that worked just fine, but I just want to change something real quick because it's bothering me. I just want to give a space when you enter your name in. Okay, let's assume that we have a very long username. So let's try this again then. Bro. My username for other things is usually Prometheus, so let's use that. Prometheus, 42069WTFBBQ. That looks like a good username to me. Your name can't be over 12 characters long. So that's a good use of the length function. Oh, and another thing with the length function, and actually many functions, is that you don't necessarily need to assign this to a variable. We could just take this, delete it, and then place this within our if statement. So this would actually work just the same within less steps, even though it's a little more complex, I would say, but it takes up less lines of code. So let's try it. So bro 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's move on to the empty function. So you can use a string.empty function to determine if any characters were placed within that string. And a good use of this is that if you prompt for a name and somebody just skips it by hitting enter, we can actually determine if that string is actually empty then. So let's try this then. We'll put this within our if statement. First underscore name, and we're going to use the dot empty function. And then we need a set of parentheses. So if the first name is empty, it's going to execute our if statement. If not, it's going to use the else statement. So we can create a prompt such as, you didn't enter a name. Okay, let's see if this actually works then. Enter your first name. I'm just going to hit enter. You didn't enter a name. Then let's try it again, but put a name in. So bro, welcome bro. The clear function will clear the contents of a string, so it's useful if you need to reset something. So in this little program I wrote, we just have a basic welcome message that displays welcome, and then your first name or username, whatever you enter. It'll say that your name has been cleared. We'll actually clear it by typing in the string that we want to clear. So first underscore name dot clear parentheses, then a semicolon, and then we will display that welcome message one more time then. So let's see if this works. Enter your first name, bro. Welcome, bro. Your name has been cleared. And then it says welcome, and then nothing after that because our first name string is now cleared or emptied. So that's useful if you need to like clear out a form or some user input. Just use the clear function. The append function will allow you to add one string onto another. So a good use for this is that imagine that you are prompted for a username, and then we can actually append an email extension to the end of that to create an email address. So let's create a string called email, and this will hold the newly appended string. So we will append our username, so username. So this is the string that's getting appended to, dot, then append, parentheses, semicolon. Make sure it's outside the parentheses though. All right, so we can put a string in here to append to this username, our first string. So let's add a gmail.com email address, and then we're just going to display this. Okay, enter your username. I'll type in bro. Your email is now bro@gmail.com. I'm pretty sure that's taken. The at function will return a character at a given index that you specify. So we're going to write a program that will extract the initials from a first name, a middle name, and a last name. So let's create a char variable. So this returns a character value. So we'll call this char value perhaps letter one equals then your first underscore name, then at. Then next we need to place a position of which letter we want to check or extract. If you want the very first character or letter, just put it in zero because it's a computer science thing. Like all arrays basically, or strings start at index zero. All right, so then let's do the same thing for the middle name and the last name. So let's call this letter two, middle name, letter three, last name. And then let's display this. See out, your initials are, then we will display letter one, letter two, and letter three. Okay. Enter your first name, bro. Enter your middle name, I'm going to make up something, Max, like maximum. And last name, Washington. Your initials are BMW. And if we change the index for this at function, we would actually extract a different letter. So let's see what our initials are now. So, bro, Max, Washington. My initials are Ra, because it's technically the second character within each of these string variables now. So that's how you can check to see which character is at a certain position in a string, and then this function will return that as a character that you can use for other things. The substring function will return a portion of a string, and it's called a substring. So an example of this, let's create a program that you'll enter in a first name, and then we'll take a small sample of that and create a nickname for you. So let's create a string named nickname. Let's say that we want to take the first three letters of your name and create a substring out of it called nickname. So we'll type in the string that we want to use. So first underscore name dot sub str for substring, then a set of parentheses, semicolon. Okay, so there's two things that we're going to want to fill out. The first is the starting position. So let's say that we want to start the substring at the first character of your first name. We're going to put zero here. Let's say that we want to retrieve the first three letters, perhaps. So we'll put three here. If you want four letters, then just put four. So let's stick with three then. And then we're just going to display this nickname. Let's try this. Enter your first name. Let's type in my full username of Brometheus. And it says, your nickname is Bro. Hello, Bro. Okay, so we can actually change where we want to take our sample for our substring. Let's say that we want to move this to position 3. And we want to extend this for 5 characters now. So we're going to take another sample of our first name, our string, and we'll get a different substring then. So, Prometheus, I don't know what this is going to be. Your nickname is meth, like crystal meth, I guess. The insert function is very similar to the append function, but we can take a string and then place it anywhere within another string. We just have to give the position in which we want to insert this other string. So this actually doesn't return anything. And this insert function doesn't actually return anything. It currently edits the string that you're currently working on. So let's take our username, dot, then insert, set of parentheses. So there's two fields to fill out. The first is the position in which you want to insert something. So let's say that we want to insert a string or a character at the very first position. So we're going to put 0, comma, then what we want to insert. Let's say that we want to insert the at symbol, like we're replying to somebody. So we'll just put this index at 0 then, and then we'll insert this at sign, this string. So let's try this. Enter your username, bro code. And it inserted a at symbol before our actual username at index 0. So let's place this somewhere else. How about at position 3? So let's try this again, bro code. And it placed this at symbol at position 3 within our string. So it's kind of like we pushed these two parts of our string to the side and it inserted this right in the middle. This find function is very useful because you can search for something within another string and it will return the first instance of that substring that you specify. So let's create a program where we have somebody enter in their first name or a username, and then we can search for a certain character or a string and return where it found that certain character. So this is kind of like you're on a web page, and then you can use that find feature to find some sort of text on the web page, and it's going to return where it found that first instance of that certain text that you specified. So it's the same concept, really. So this will return a integer value, and we'll call this position equals. We want to search our first string that was called first underscore name dot find. And what do we want to find? We'll find a substring, our variable substring. All right, so let's run this. So we can actually decide on what we want to search for with this. Enter your first name. I'm just going to type in bro code. Search for which character. I want to find any C's in here, capital C's. It found this character at position 3, so 0, 1, 2, 3. That's kind of cool, right? So this is the erase function. We can erase a portion of a string. One use for this. So do you know with phone numbers how they usually begin with an area code? Well, let's prompt for the user to enter in a phone number, and then we'll erase the area code, leaving whatever the rest is. So we'll use the string phone number dot erase. Then we need to place a starting position, a starting index. Let's say we want to erase the first 4 characters. So it's going to start at position 0, and we're going to erase 4 characters from the string. Okay, and then we'll display it at the end. Okay, enter your phone number. I'm just going to make up something with an area code. So perhaps 101, 123, 4567. Okay. Our new phone number is 1234567, and it erased the first four characters of our phone number, so it erased that area code, basically. So, we're about out of time. There's still many more functions that we haven't covered, but if we did, we'd probably be here all day. So instead, I'll link a resource to basically a web page that contains more functions that you may or may not be interested in. But there's still a lot more that we haven't covered. These are just a few. And then if you have some free time, feel free to browse the resource I'll give you if you want to learn a few more. I'll post the source code that we worked on in the comments down below and pin it to the top. But yeah, that's the basics of using string functions in C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.